Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about finding the equation of a line, and this is a new topic for our introductory algebra students, and it's confusing for people. When you ask for the equation of a line, you could ask for standard form, slope-intercept form, point-slope form, but for now, we're going to be looking at finding the equation of a line in slope-intercept form, which is this form right here, y equals mx plus b. It's called slope-intercept form because you can see the slope and you can see the y-intercept in that format. So what I'm interested in is finding the equation of a line from a picture, and so I want to know what's my y-intercept. Well, the y-intercept is where the graph crosses the y-axis, so that's 1, 2, 3. So my y-intercept, or b, is going to be 3. This is b. It's lowercase b when you use that for y-intercept. So what I know is I have y equals, I don't replace the x, I do replace the m, and I know b now is 3 because that's where it crossed the y-axis. If it was negative, I'd put a minus 3 there. And so the other part that I need to do is figure out the slope. And to do that, I'm going to be interested in from the leftmost point to the rightmost point, how far down do I go? And how far over do I go? Because the slope is a ratio of the rise to run. So from here, I'm going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 down. That's negative 6 because I went down by 6. And then I'm going over 2. Well, negative 6 over 2, you know, can be reduced to negative 3. So my slope is negative 3. That my slope is a relationship between the rise and the run. Rise can be negative if you're going down. Run can be negative if you're going backwards. So now I know I have negative 3x plus 3. I'm going to rewrite that so you can see the negative more plainly. And that's their final, that's the equation. That's what we're looking for. In all these problems, we're asking you to figure out what the m and the b is. Okay, so this new equation that I'm looking at here is the point-slope equation. And the point-slope equation looks very different than the slope-intercept. Some people don't even teach this. They don't use it. They just jump directly to this. And if you know a different method to find that, that's fine. But on the program that we're using, they frequently ask you to give the point-slope equation. So we're going to learn how to use it and when to use it. When you use the point-slope equation when given a point, and the point is your x sub 1 and your y sub 1 in this equation. You can see I've circled them. These are the ones that we're going to be replacing. And the slope, which is m. So we want to take this equation, and we want to replace y sub 1, m, and x sub 1 with numbers. That would give us the point-slope equation. This is not as simplified as much as it can be. It's not meant to be. It's meant to show us the point and the slope. Okay, so this examples then, find the equation in point-slope and in slope-intercept form. So we want both of those. And we're going to be given, in this first one, we're given that the slope is 3 and it's passing through negative 6, 3. So I'm going to start with the point-slope equation. The point-slope equation is y minus y sub 1 is m times x minus x sub 1. So I'm going to replace those three things that I said we were going to replace. So the y is 3. This is your x sub 1, and this is your y sub 1, and this is your m. So y sub 1 is 3, so I'm going to say y minus 3, and then m, well, m is 3. Now here's where it gets a little tricky. Be careful because we have x is negative 6 and we have a subtraction in here too. So if I put minus negative 6, that's not quite simplified as much as I want it to be. So when you're doing this on the computer or whatever, we don't want you to put minus and minus. What should that be? Well, then in simplest form, that should be 3 and then x plus 6. That's how you should write that. Minus a minus is going to make a plus. And I'll remind you, hey, we got two negatives there, make that a plus. So this is point slope form. And that's the final answer for point slope form. And now we want to do slope intercept. Sometimes in this program, they ask you for slope intercept only. Sometimes they ask you for point slope only. Sometimes they ask you for both. Read the directions. Even if you want slope intercept, you can use the point slope form to get you to that. So how do we get to slope intercept? Well, I'm going to take my point slope form of the equation, and then I'm going to solve it and get y by itself, because slope intercept has y by itself. So we want to solve that by to get it by itself. So I have y minus 3 equals 3x plus 18. That's just distributing that 3. And then I'm going to add 3 to both sides, and I get y equals 3x, 18 plus 3 is 21. And there's my point or slope intercept form. So I have the point slope form, and then I just use that to simplify that to get the slope intercept form. All right, what about if I ask you to do the same thing, but you're passing through a slope that's 1/5? So you have a fraction in there. No problem. We're going to start by subtracting the y's and then m and subtract your x's. The final answer has the y in it. It has the x in it. We need to get rid of the x sub 1 and the y sub 1. So I want to think about this as x sub 1 and y sub 1, and the m is obvious. Okay, so I'm going to subtract negative 9. If I subtract a negative, what should I be putting in there? I should be putting plus 9. Just like we saw up here, minus a minus is going to make that a plus. So I get y plus 9. And then my slope is negative 1/5. And then x is 5, x sub 1 is 5 rather, so x minus 5. There's my point slope form. I'm done with that. Now I want to rearrange that to get y by itself to get slope intercept form. So I have nothing, I'm not doing anything on the left. I have negative 1/5 x. Negative 1/5 times negative 5 is positive 1. You can do that off to the side or use your calculator or whatever. Now all I have to do is subtract 9, and I get y equals negative 1/5 x minus 8. That's slope intercept form. This is point slope form. You need to know the difference, which is which, right? Slope intercept form is always that form where you have y by itself. Point slope form, it's called that because in order to create this, you need a point and a slope. So it's kind of named very nicely. All right. And then what if you were just asked to rewrite something into slope intercept form? This right now is in point slope form. And we've already done two of those, but just taking a look at this, we get 1/4 x plus 5, 1/4 of 20. And then we're going to add 4 to both sides. So sometimes you might be asked to find just the point slope. Sometimes you ask just to find the slope intercept. Sometimes they give you this and ask you for slope intercept. But my point is you're going to be asked for a specific type of equation, and you have to be clear on which is which to answer that question correctly. All right. Have a fantastic day. We'll see you next time.